Over 700 participants will be in this high-tech evacuation simulator that will see if the size of the seats affects the speed of evacuation. The study will look at seat width and pitch, which is the distance from one seat back to the back of the seat in front of it. It will also factor in population demographics, specifically people of different sizes.
This is the first in which we're going to look specifically at seat pitch. We have looked at egress times with other varying conditions in the past.
The study is mandated by the FAA Reauthorization Act of 2018. Because it's the first study of its kind, it's entirely possible there could be no relation between seat size and evacuation time.
A test like exactly like this, looking at just these parameters, has never been done before. And so that's why we're really excited to see the outcome of it.
The study will not look at children or disabled passengers or the 90-second rule, which experts say is a misconception. There is no regulation that says an airplane has to be evacuated in 90 seconds.
What we're trying to do is limit the number of parameters we're studying so the data shows us clearly whether the seat pitch and width is affecting the problem. We don't want to muddy the water with all these other parameters. It's just not good science.
But will the results of this study allow airlines to make their seats even smaller? The FAA says it's not up to them to decide how the data is used.
A rulemaking committee will be taking our data. Our people will be used as subject matter experts to be able to interpret the data that we have for that committee's use. And they will be making larger decisions associated with any changes that are necessary.
A final report is expected to be released next summer. Angela Shen, Oklahoma's News 4.
Angela, thank you. The study will be conducted over 12 days in November and December. The FAA says they will have information later about getting participants signed up in them.